Hey guys, I do a little upgrading on the little studio here. For a couple of years now, I've been using a softbox that is slowly falling apart. So I decided to pick up some new lights. I couldn't find anything or any reviews on this model. So I guess I'm going to do a little review here. This model here runs on the Neewer app that you can pick up on the Play Store. Other than that, it's pretty much the same as most of their other models. All aluminum construction, including the barn doors, are aluminum. You can actually remove it from these screws there. But, there you go. And then there's a filter in between there with a little clip to hold it in. You can slip it out. Sort of slips out. Well, it does slip out, but oh, here we go. Just want to take a look at the LEDs. I haven't had a look at it yet, so. Youch. Not easy to do. Get these hinges in the way. There we go. There's your filter. Yeah, I can't see it getting too hot. I mean, the LEDs aren't SMD. They're not soldered right to the board. So the only heat that's going to be transferred to the heat sink or the aluminum plate is through the legs of the LED, which is much. So. Let's plug it in and give it a try. There's the back. All digital. You can use two batteries with it, which I don't have. Nice. The adjustment knobs are clickable. And out there, I think it's for the linking that up to your phone. It's got the two settings, one is for power and one is for battery. Alright, let's take a look at the transformer. Some people had complaints that these weren't long enough. They said the leads were too short. Well, when you get the cord on top of that, I mean, it's pretty good. But the cord is pretty long as well. No complaints there. And I like that it's got the case, so you can pack it up nice and neat, which I didn't have for my softbox when I bought it. And moving it was a pain. Oops. Pickles. Okay, there is one thing I noticed. The picture in their ad, and this one is different. On the ad, they had a picture of a 12-volt socket that was more industrial, like it was bolted right to the frame of the light. This one here is loose fitting, and it's not going to take much abuse before that breaks free. I figured I'd bring that up. That was one of those features that I saw on the light that I was interested in because I knew it could take some abuse before it failed, but that's not going to take much to fail. Alright, let's plug it in and try it out. Maybe the one underneath is different. We'll take a look at it. Ooh, nice. Yep, so that's the power pack. Your light's intensity. Oh, I don't know about that. It's. I wouldn't say it's like you definitely would need two of them. I wouldn't say it's the brightest. Well, okay. Well, there's full intensity there. That's not bad. If you use warm white, it's very bright, but if you use white, it's very dim. It's not that, it's not very bright. It says it's it heats up as well over on the top here. Just let it sit for a minute and see if it gets hot. It doesn't get very hot. The case is mildly warm, but not hot. Actually, what generates quite a bit of heat is a little heat sink above the display. It's more than likely there's a regulator in there. You can change, with this button here, you can change the channel of the light. Like, you have multiple lights for the app. I'll show you how the app works. It'll take a while for it to pick up the product. it took a bit. It kept saying that I couldn't find it. As I might do now. Connect fail. But then when you go to connect, now it doesn't want to work. Yeah, they're a little flaky. I think it's the software. Let me get it connected and we'll try it out. Okay, it took a bit. I ended up changing the channel from channel 5 to channel 8. It is pretty responsive. It's warm, cold, and a couple of other settings in there. Not bad. And then you can change the light you're trying to control up here. It goes from 1 to 8. Yeah, so that's it. I'm going to try hanging them up and see if I can get some better lighting. Well, let's look one light up. It throws quite a bit of light. This one came with instructions. The other one didn't. Quick look at it. It's the power plug is pretty much the same, so it's not like one was a different model or anything like that. Okay, well, setup was pretty easy to do. If you're hanging them from the ceiling, you can basically use a long 4-inch drywall screw and a nut on the end, just so it has something to latch on to. I have one set up at channel 0 and one at 8. It takes a bit, I don't know if it's my phone or if it's the app, but it takes a bit for it to find the light, so you'll have to give it a few tries. But I got to work with both of them now. As you can see, I can turn it right down, or right off. So it's pretty responsive, even with both, as well as with color. I find in the middle is the best. It's cream, but it's cold. It's warm and cold. 440 is the best. That's it, guys. Later.